On the 17th of September 1908, Lieutenant Thomas E. Selfridge of the US Army became the first person to die in an airplane crash. Welcome to History Pod. The US Army had shown interest in developing heavier-than-air flying machines for military purposes, and Orville Wright was scheduled to demonstrate the Wright Model A Flyer as part of a series of trials at Fort Myer in Virginia. Thomas Selfridge, a 26-year-old officer in the US Army Signal Corps, had worked with Alexander Graham Bell's Aerial Experiment Association, so already had experience flying in experimental aircraft. He consequently volunteered to fly as Wright's passenger in the demonstration flight. The aircraft carried two people, with the pilot lying prone on the lower wing and the passenger seated upright. The flight began uneventfully, with the flyer circling the parade ground, reaching an altitude of about 150 feet. On the fourth circuit, however, a propeller blade split and broke apart, striking one of the wires that controlled the rudder. This damage caused the aircraft to lose stability, and despite Orville Wright's efforts to regain control, the plane pitched forward sharply and crashed nose first into the ground. Wright was badly injured, suffering multiple fractures and bruises, but survived. Selfridge, however, struck his head and fractured his skull, as early aviators did not wear protective headgear. Although he was taken to a nearby hospital, he died a few hours later. Selfridge's death marked the first recorded fatality in the history of powered flight. The crash drew attention to the need for more robust construction of aircraft and, eventually, to the introduction of helmets for pilots and passengers. Yet, despite the tragedy, the Army did not abandon its interest in aviation, and within a year, the Wright brothers delivered an aircraft that met the Army's requirements. Thank you.